हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, माय सेल्फ राकेश सर फ्रॉम संत माइकल स्कूल। इन दिस पार्ट ऑफ वीडियो आई टीच द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 6 एंड टुडे द न्यू चैप्टर 16 एंड द नेम ऑफ चैप्टर इज वाटर ए नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज। अकॉर्डिंग टू सिलेबस दिस इज द लास्ट चैप्टर फॉर क्लास 6 because 5 chapters already left for this year, so this is the last chapter, so you will try to learn and also note down all the important topics related to it. So in this chapter we all study about water, what is water and also their importance. So at first we all try to know about the introduction of water. You all know that water is called a wonderful liquid, and also there is a great importance of water on the earth's surface, and according to their function water is also called a wonder liquid. There is no any alternative of water. So it is said that water is life. Without water, nobody can survive on the earth's surface. All the living beings need water for their survival. And also, all the functions and activity occurs in our body only by the help of water. So, without water, we could not do anything. And it is said that the total weight of our body, suppose the total weight of our body is 60 kg, then water present in our body is 2/3 multiply 60, 40 kg. It means 2/3 of the body weight water present in our body. This also shows the importance of water in our body. And the water present on the earth's surface, as you know, on the whole earth, we divide into 4 parts. Then 3 parts cover with water and 1 part only land part. So, 75% part of the earth's surface covered with water. So it is said that huge amount of water present on the earth's surface. But it is also a fact that, and a burning question, that water available for our usage. Water available for our usage on the earth's surface and their percentage. Huge amount of water present on earth, but very little amount of water present on the earth's surface, which are useful for our all activities. According to data, total water present 100%. According to 100%, 97% water present in sea and oceans. 97% water present on the earth's surface found in sea and ocean. And rest 2% in the form of glaciers. Glacier means there is a huge rocks of ice floating on the water body on the upper surface and also on the north and south pole of the earth. Huge amount of glaciers present and also water present in the frozen form. This is called glacier due to very low temperature.
And this 1% water left. In this water, maximum water is present here and there and only 0.01% water present on the earth's surface useful for us. Only 0.1
only 0.1% water present on the earth surface are useful for all living beings. It means we all utilize only 0.01% water present on the earth surface. So huge amount of water present here, but only few amount of water are available in river, lakes, ponds, well, and also underground water, which are utilized by us. This shortness of water available on the earth surface for our utilization present here, and also there is a this short amount of water makes most valuable natural resources. So we should always try to keep safe water and also never try to misuse water present on the earth surface.
So everybody always try to keep safe and don't misuse the water present here. Now sources of water. Water we all obtain from the earth surface, from the ponds, lakes, wells, rivers, sea and ocean. These are the sources of water. But as you know, sea and ocean, the water present here, this water is saline water. Saline means salty water. Saline means salty water. So we could not utilize the water of sea and ocean for our use because huge amount of approximately 30% salt mixing in the water. So these are not utilized by us. We all utilize only ponds, lakes, wells and rivers water for our use. Now the important topic, this natural resources present on the earth, and also it is called a wonderful liquid. Why? This is also a question. Why water is called a wonderful liquid? There are two important reasons for this. First, water present on the earth. This is found in three states: solid, liquid, and gaseous. Water present on the earth is present in three states: solid, liquid and gases. Solid means ice, liquid means water, and gas means water vapor. So in this all states water present on the earth surface, and no any other substance present on the earth surface, they are found in three states. This nature of water makes this wonder liquid. Second, water has capacity to dissolve large number of substances in it. This also makes great or wonder liquid. So these two important topics related to water, and this makes water a wonderful liquid. Now, water cycle in nature. This water present on earth surface and also called important resources, natural resources, and never finish this water from the earth surface. Everybody utilize this, but this again come back in the nature due to the nature of cycling, recycling. Water cycle, this is called water cycle. So some important things makes important thing and also again come on the earth surface: evaporation, transpiration, and also respiration. These are the process through which this water move in the water form, in the water vapor form in the nature, and again come back on the earth surface. Now these all topics we all understand by the help of water cycle. This water cycle play important role and also help in never ending the water on the earth surface. Now what is water cycle? This is a question. What is water cycle? Their answer: constant circulation of water
from earth surface to atmosphere and again back to the earth surface. This is called water cycle. Means constant circulation of water from earth surface to atmosphere and again come back on the earth surface. This is called water cycle. And for this function, three steps are needed: evaporation, condensation and precipitation. First topic, evaporation. As you know, there are different water bodies present on the earth surface. And from the water body, water evaporates and also in the form of water vapor move in the atmosphere. Evaporation and respiration and transpiration, by all process water enter in the atmosphere in the form of water vapor. And also in the atmosphere, due to lower temperature, they condense and also form in the tiny water droplets. And these tiny water droplets forming due to low temperature, and this process is called condensation. So condensation is the process by which all the substances change into tiny water droplets due to low temperature. Now in the last precipitation, this is the process of falling down of rain in the form of water, hail, hailstones. It means in the different form of water falling down on the earth surface is called precipitation. So water cycle including three steps: evaporation, condensation and precipitation. By these three processes, this water always continue in the nature and they are also present and available for the all living beings every time and never destroyed. So we all always try to keep safe this water on the earth surface. In this part of video, I complete it. Thank you.